Hey guys, Vikas over here and this is We Are Genius. Guys, today I am with a new video around Arduino. We'll see how to get started with the smallest Arduino compatible board available from DigiSpark. Guys, this miniaturized Arduino board is developed around 8085 microcontroller, which comes with 8 kb of flash, from which actually 2 kb is used for the Arduino bootloader and remaining 6 kb is available for the user. And it comes with 16.5 MHz clock. The board features 6 GPIO pins which supports SPI and I2C communication using USB as well as digital and analog I/O along with PWM support. Now over here, this is the board I've got, and this comes with unsoldered like male headers. Okay, so over here it shows the P0 to P5, the 6 GPIO pins, and you get power pins over here. So this has onboard voltage regulator, the microcontroller with some discrete components, and this features a micro USB port. This like the Arduino or the miniaturized Arduino board what I am having over here, this comes in 2 flavors. One is directly pluggable into the USB pinball socket, and one which I am having over here is having a USB or micro USB socket on the board. And compared to Arduino Pro Mini, which I am having over here, it measures 1 cm shorter in the length only, and all width and everything is quite same with the Arduino Pro Mini, which features 3.2 × 1.8 cm. But the advantage is like it comes with onboard USB, which doesn't require the like USB to UART converter as compared to the Arduino Pro Mini. But this DigiSpark Arduino module features less GPIO as compared to Arduino Pro Mini. So to get started with this DigiSpark module, we just need one USB cable to be connected to our PC to this module, and we need to tweak around the drivers, and we need to add the board support to the Arduino IDE. So guys, let's get to the PC, let's get started. So guys, this is the DigiSpark Arduino module diagram over here I am having, and it shows you the different pins and the components present over here. So this is the module guys that plugs into the USB socket directly, and the micro USB only replaces this portion or the USB connectors over here with the micro USB socket. Okay. So coming onto the pins, it features 6 GPIO pins, out of which 2 pins like the D3 and D4 are used for USB plus and minus, which actually again used for programming the Arduino board. And all pins are almost multiplexed, like D5 is again act as A0 pin or the analog pin, and it supports SPI as well as I2C. But this board doesn't come with hardware serial. So if you are interested in serial communication, you can opt to software serial. So to get started with this, before plugging the Arduino module to the computer, we just need to download the drivers and install it onto our PC. To do that, head over to your browser and look for GStomp website. So I've actually given the link down below so that you can download the drivers directly. So over here, on the website, click on the GitHub link for the drivers. So that should download the required drivers onto your. Now after the download completes, move into your download folder and unzip the GStomp driver zip folder. Unzip it. Now after unzipping, you should see something like this. So over here, just click on installdrivers.exe. Click on yes.
and that should let you through some like installation instructions. Okay, after the completion you should see something like this. It has installed drivers for LIBUSB devices and all. Okay, click on finish. Now navigate to the same web page and over here copy this link, the index.json that we need to add our Digispark board to our Arduino IDE, and open up your Arduino IDE. So if you're looking for this link, I have given the link down below in the description. So over here in Arduino IDE, move to preferences, and in the additional board managers URLs, you can paste on the URL. Actually, I have posted like made it earlier, so it is already there. If you are not edit, you can edit over here. Click on OK, and the tools, go to board manager and look for your Digispark this one, Digistomp AVR boards by Digistomp. Okay, now actually I have already installed, but if you have not installed earlier, you should see install menu over here. Just click on that, nothing else. Okay, so after installing your boot support to the Arduino IDE, under file menu you should see some sketches already there. Okay, like over here the Digispark examples, Digispark CDC, Alif, all the things. So click on the start sketch. Okay, now this is a default program that blinks the LED each 1 second. So let's change this program bit. I'm just changing the duration. I'm not going to save it, but I just wanted to verify. But don't hit on the upload button, be careful about that. So actually the thing is, before hitting the upload button, you don't need to connect your Digispark module to your PC, because the Digispark module checks only for programming mode for the first 5 seconds as soon as it get connected to the USB port. So first press the upload button, and after that we'll see something like connect or plug in your device now, and it waits for 60 seconds. Now you can plug in your Digispark Arduino module. Now as soon as you plug in your Digispark Arduino module, you should see something message like micro nucleus done, thank you. Okay, now our sketch has been successfully uploaded to the Arduino module. Okay, so actually I just installed my drivers earlier and I just plugged in my Digispark module, so it got installed directly. But if you are connecting your Digispark module for the first time, it will take some time to install the drivers. It should do it automatically. So the PC will automatically recognize your Digispark module. So guys, that's all with this. I hope I'll come with some other videos around the Digispark Arduino module. Till then, stay tuned. Thank you. Thanks for watching.
Hey guys, it's me once again, and hope you have liked my video. If so, just hit the thumbs up button. If you don't, there is a thumbs down button for you also. And don't forget to subscribe my channel for latest updates. Okay, see you next time with my new content. That's all guys. Thank you. Thanks for watching.